Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Lieutenant General Khalid Maqbool sir, Senator Javed Jaddar sir, Major General Hafiz Masroor Ahmed, Shakil Ahmed Rami sir, and General Jafri sir. It is indeed an honor and my privilege to welcome all of you in Punjab University in this Ali Razi Hall. I think a month back, your team, the CGSS team, communicated with me through email that we are this center and our objective is this one. And fortunately, on that day, General Khalid Maqbool sir was here about the, one of the program in Punjab University. And finally, we were finalizing how this program should take place. So I requested them that this General Khalid Maqbool, because I knew him when he was the Chancellor, he was the governor of the large province, Punjab. So the academic community knows his potential and the way he worked. I immediately said that General Khalid Maqbool sir should be taken as a chief guest, thanks to your team, sir. And General sir, you accepted our request. This higher education institution where we are sitting today, this University of the Punjab, one of the oldest institutions, and I have been talking to my colleagues, my students when they are graduating, and from time to time when I am having a seminar or conferences with them, all the time my focus is to my students and to the faculty, kindly recognize from which institution you belong, the largest institution, the biggest institution, the oldest institution of the country, having 137 years of history, and what is our scope? Simply delivering the lectures in the classroom, this is our scope? Not at all. The higher education institution, whether it is a Punjab University, or any other international higher education institution, the scope is much higher. The higher education institutions, these are giving directions to the nation. These are building the nations. I think without any doubt, taking a few seconds, not taking even a few seconds, when they contacted me that we want to have this nation building program in Punjab University, I said, warm welcome. This is my scope. This is the scope of the higher education institution. You people are building the nation. And if we are not aware of that, then it means this is a very unfortunate. And the knowledge, what is the three prime objective of the higher education institution? Creation of knowledge, transfer of knowledge, and building a civilized society, inculcating the moral values in the students. I think with these three prime objectives, my faculty members, my students, they have been working and they have been studying in this oldest institution of the country. But the scope of the higher education institutions, the objectives, these have changed. We cannot live in 100 years, 20 years back when this Higher Education Commission was established and we were getting just a funding from the UGC and we were just delivering the lecture. It is more than that. And kindly, the solution of problems, the knowledge, the innovation, integration of the societies, these are coming from the higher education institution. I remember in 2001 to my Vice Chancellor General Ashraf Mahmood sahab, he called me that, Dr. Sahab, can we start a quality program in Punjab University? I said, why not, sir? It is very important. I was just back from Bahrain. So when I talked to the director, unhone mujhe kaha ki, Dr. Sahab, ye ek murda ghoda hai, kya aap isko utha sakte hain, quality ke upar aap kaam karna chahte hain. Finally, we decided, yes, we are going for it. It was 2002. In 2005, Higher Education Commission, They came with the quality assurance mechanism, quality assurance agency, quality assurance model in higher education institution. And in 2007, we built the Institute of Quality and Technology Management. We were talking about the quality of education, quality of food, quality of health. All the time we were advocating. And today, everybody is talking about the quality of education, quality, everything with, related with the quality. I remember about 10 months back when my team, my students and my faculty, we said we have no other options except the institution, the Punjab University will be run on merit, transparency, rule of law. We define the core values of the institution. And today, even on the televisions, on the talk show, you see the people are talking about the merit, transparency, that the boards which you can see around the university, now everybody is talking about these boards are signed the core value. Why I am saying these two examples I have given? The university is giving direction to the nation. When we said about the quality, the people were saying about the quality. When we said these are the core principles, governing principles of the nation, then today the people are talking about these principles. Therefore, I congratulate this CGSS that when they selected that we should go and Punjab University and the higher education institution, I think this was the success, that was the right approach from the this center, bringing the academia, the universities, all together for the nation building, which was the prime objective, prime mission of the institution. My students and my faculty, the higher education institutions, which is a bridge, which is an important pillar of building the nation, I think you people who are sitting here, we are the luckiest one. We have been associated with this Punjab University, the oldest institution. How many of you? About 9% of you, you were admitted in Punjab University, 91% were refused because of the capacity. 150,000 people applied in Punjab University for admission. Only 9% secured the admission. And this is 46,000 student body in the university. You are the luckiest one. Today, sir, Punjab University charged $1 per month for a room rent. How much cheaper we are. If you compare any of the private sector with this Punjab University, there is no comparison. Therefore, we have to realize, if I have been telling you today, this Punjab University, you know it well, this is a service organization. We are providing education to the people. But the service organizations, then we will ultimately combine with this nation building. If we will not look into these, we will not realize our importance. You can see the service organization, for example, if I say the railway, Pakistan Railway, PIA, Pakistan Telecommunication Company, PTCL, all these were well-known services organizations. But today, these organizations didn't exist. The reason is, they didn't care the community. They didn't care the stakeholders. Therefore, you people, my faculty members, if you will not take care of the quality, the scope which has been defined for the higher education institution, you will be replaced by someone else. Thanks to the General Sahab was saying about the Pakistan Army and the defense forces, we are the luckiest one. You can see how brilliant, brave soldiers we have. One of my professor friend from Malaysia, he asked me, Dr. Saab, what is the size of your organization, your country, and you are competing with India? I said, yes, number one force of the world, defense forces, the Pakistani force. You can click it, you will find they are the number one in the world. We have this Pakistan force, supplemented with the science and technology, engineers. You can see, concluding this one, No country, yes, you will find these things started from the history, wherever you name it. It started, the enemies are there. But I should tell you, sir, Pakistan is so safe, so secure. 60% of the population, the youngster, they are sitting here. Yes, one can think about Pakistan, but you see, one day they attack, next day they got the reply. That is the problem. Therefore, we don't need to worry. But my important point is, please realize that we need to work hard. It should be the governing principles, the governance, one issue which the country has been facing. But the message we have given to the nation, to the leaders, to the policy makers, that these will be the core values, the governing principles of the Pakistani nation. That is merit, transparency, rule of law, honesty, the governing principle, you name it, these are there, and these will define the direction of the nation. So that is why in Punjab University now, you people are witness, my faculty, my students, these are reflected in every operation of the university. Otherwise we cannot survive. Those days have gone, that Vice Chancellor is sitting in office and giving the dictation and that is implemented. No. You have to come forward. I asked one of my professors, that it was early 90s, when I was in University of Leeds. Jerry Adam, that was a freedom fighter for the island, he visited USA. And he was given a state guest protocol in US. I asked in the morning, Professor, what happened? This Jerry Adam, you know what he is doing, what are his activities, and he is being received by Bill Clinton like a state guest. He said, Niaz, this is the scope of my Prime Minister John Major. Let us see how he reacts. After a week, when he was back, John Major flew to USA and he was received by Bill Clinton and the same Rostam, both of them were again together, and Bill Clinton was saying that Jerry Adam is a terrorist and we stand with the UK government. So it is that, what I gave you this example, our scope of the higher education institution is to unify the nation, build the nation. The leadership, it is the scope of the leadership, how they define what should be done for that, what the direction should be given to the society or to the nation. It is their scope. However, we must select a role model leadership. Alhamdulillah, Pakistan is on the track and the institutions are performing, the governing principles are there. However, this education which General Sahib has selected, this Punjab University, this seminar should be held, I think we should have these dialogues in the higher education institution. I know some of the Danishwar, so-called, talking about the different agenda, the players are sitting outside. General Sahib has very wisely hinted about them. I think when the nation is integrated one, no country can think of it, but we should be vigilant. And remember, the innovation, the knowledge transfer, that will be coming from the higher education institution and mainly from Punjab University. Please, if Punjab University is not doing this job, do you think Bahawalpur, DG Khan, Saiwal, Ukhara University, new babies will complete these tasks? No, it is your school. And you have to give the direction to the nation. And lastly, that is about the technology. I always say, if the organization, the countries, they have to flourish, they have to go forward, the technology is important. the social system, the management system, and third one is the technology system. If you are integrating these three systems, I hope that Pakistan is a very beautiful, with a lot of potential, with a lot of brains, and I'm sure no country can think of it. Pakistan is, alhamdulillah, in the safe hand. It is progressing, and it is now our responsibility. You young people who are sitting here, the potential Pakistan has got. Any one of you gets PhD degree, immediately Pakistani higher education institution, they are waiting. Please come forward. We will take you as assistant professor. Whereas in the other institutions, other than Pakistan, people have got PhD, one postdoc, second postdoc, and they are waiting that they should be inducted as a lecturer. How much scope you people have got? But this is not sufficient that you have got the Punjab University degree and you say that this is the degree from the oldest institution and please provide me the job. No way. Those days have gone. But you need to work very hard. The position, top positions are vacant for you. And lot of opportunities for my young people, my youngster who are in the higher education institution. Pakistan is full of opportunity. Someone was telling me about India. PhD people are applying for the attendant job. This is their situation. No opportunity. Whereas in our country, the top position is always vacant, but you must have the knowledge and you must have the skill. And alhamdulillah, the peoples are working. Thank you very much, General Sir. You provided us this opportunity. Your colleague was saying that we will provide the lunch or the other whatever is resources required. I said, no, this is my job. I'm grateful that you have shared this one with us. We are grateful to you. This is a giant project. Punjab University will be always partner with you. This is a common objective of the Pakistani people, and we are united. Thank you very much. I have taken your time. Pakistan, Zindabad. Thank you.